Gutenberg. The new WordPress editor is progressing nicely and will be merged with WordPress core in 5.0 release. It's a lot to keep track of, but also exciting. In the words of Matt Mullenweg, the editor will endeavor to create a new page and post building experience that makes writing rich posts effortless and has blocks to make it easy what today might take shortcodes, custom HTML, or mystery meet embed discovery. While the current focus is on content creation, the eventual goal is to have Gutenberg go beyond the post into page templates and ultimately full site customization. That means eventually you'll be able to build your whole site using Gutenberg, including landing pages and other relevant content. A second ago, I told you that Gutenberg is a block-based editor. It was kind of rude to leave you hanging because, if you're like most people, you might not know what that means. So, here's block-based editing 101. Essentially, Gutenberg replaces the single edit field on the current WordPress TinyMCE editor with lots of individual blocks. These blocks then allow you to build more complex designs than those permitted in the current WordPress editor. So, what's a block? Well, a block can be pretty much anything. For example, you can have blocks for regular text, images, video embeds, buttons, widgets, yes, those same widgets you use in your sidebar, tables, etc. Moreover, what's neat is that developers will be able to create their third-party blocks that you can access via plugins for even more flexibility. Each block is its entity that you can manipulate on an individual basis. Watch how quickly I can rearrange those blocks just by clicking a button. And because each block is separate, you can also add things like custom backgrounds just for specific blocks. In general, it gives you more flexibility and in-depth control. Not quite. At least, not in its current form. Gutenberg is going to make it a lot easier to regular style content, like blog posts or standard pages. But it's not a complete substitute for page builders in its current form. This all-new WordPress editor is poised to eliminate the need for page builders for most standard content. And it also creates a single unified method for creating more complex post layouts. But when it comes to building more complex pages, like a landing page, you're probably going to appreciate the greater flexibility offered by page builders, at least during Gutenberg's initial release. For example, in our comparison between Elementor versus Divi Builder versus Beaver Builder, you can see how the top page builders offer much more things. Gutenberg might get there someday, but at least in its initial release form, page builders will still give you the flexibility to design more complicated standalone pages. While Gutenberg has its detractors, it's still coming in WordPress 5.0. For most casual users, it will, after some growing pains, bring a more flexible content creation experience. Non-developers will be able to craft more complex layouts with extra elements, like buttons, intuitively, content embeds, and lots more. And that will, hopefully, help WordPress to continue to grow. until WordPress 5.0 ships, you can play around with the WordPress Gutenberg editor by installing the plugin. And if you'd like to keep on top of the latest Gutenberg's updates, you can follow along with the Gutenberg tag at Make WordPress Core. Now, we'd love to hear from you. I'm sure many of you have strong thoughts on Gutenberg, so let us know about it in the comments. See you in the next video.